Hi everyone, my name is Sikap Larbi Perez and now I will be presenting to all of you the Chapter 2, which is entitled Essential Requisites of Contract with corresponding Article of 1318 to 1324. Article 1318, it refers that there is no contract unless the following requisites concurs. These are the consent, object, and cause. The first one, consent of the contracting parties. Dito sa consent, dapat ang dalawang parties or involved sa contract ay nagkakaunawan or may naganap na or sumang-ayon sila parehas. The next one is object certain, which is the subject matter of the contract. Dito naman sa object, which is the subject matter, dapat ang dalawang parties ay alam nila or tukoy nila kung ano ba yung bagay na pinag-uusapan nila. And then, third one is cause of the obligation, which is established. Mayroon akong example dito ng tatlong requisites. The first one is example of consent. Ricky offers to buy Martin's car. The offer is made over the phone. Unknown to Ricky, it is not Martin at the other end of the line, but his younger brother Ariel, who can perfectly mimic his elder brother's voice. Ariel accepts Ricky's offer, successful at imitating his elder brother's voice. There is no contract here because there was no consent on Martin's part. So, sa case nila Ricky at Martin, walang contract na mangyayari dahil walang consent ni Martin because in the first place, ang kausap ni Ricky ay si Ariel instead of Martin. Gaya ng sabi ko kanina, ang contract ay dapat may consent ng bawat parties na involved doon. The next example is example of object. A student enrolls in a university and when asked what course it is that she wishes to register for, she answers, anything. The registrar carelessly receives the form and causes the entry of the student's name in the register of the university. In this case, there can be no contract sa case ng student at ng registrar ng university because it is not certain what is the university must teach the student or prepare her for. The next example is example of cause. When Marcia and Liz join her house, there will be no way Marcia can have John's house unless John's donate it to her, in which case John's liberality or generosity will be the cause of the contract. In this case, for a contract to exist between Marcia and John, Marcia must offer John something wishes in return, like for example, money or some other piece of property which will be the cause of the contract. And let's go to the classes of elements of a contract. These are essential elements, natural elements, and accidental elements. When we say essential elements, or those without which no contract can validly exist, regardless of the intentions of the parties, they are also known as requisites of a contract. Dito sa essential elements, hindi mo masasabing valid ang contract pag wala yung tatlo, yung consent, object, and cause. And they may be subdivided into two, the common and the special. When we say common, it presents in all contract, namely the consent, object, and cause. And special, it presents only in certain contracts. The second element is natural elements, or those that are presumed to exist in certain contracts unless the contrary is expressly stipulated by the parties, like warranty against eviction or warranty against hidden defects in sale. Dito sa second elements, hindi na dapat pag-usapan kasi ang presumption is kasama na talaga sa contract. Kumbaga, kaya siya tinawag na natural kasi natural talaga na nandun na siya. And the next one is accidental elements, or the particular stipulations, clauses, terms, or conditions established by the parties in their contract, like conditions, period, interest, penalty, etc. And therefore, they exist only when they are expressly provided by the parties. Dito papasok yung mga bagay na pwede nyo pang pag-usapan. Nakadepende ito sa agreement nyo, like ilang percent ang interest, mode of delivery, etc. The next article is Article 1319. Consent is manifested by the meeting of the offer and the acceptance upon the thing and the cause which are to constitute the contract. The offer must be certain and the acceptance absolute. A qualified acceptance constitutes a counteroffer. Acceptance made by letter or telegram does not find the offeror except from the time it came to his knowledge. The contract, in such a case, is presumed to have been able entered into a place where the offer was made. Let's go to the meaning of consent. Consent is giving up one's conformity to the terms of the contract freely and voluntarily. It is the concurrence of the minds of the parties on the cause and subject matter which will constitute the contract, as well as on the other conditions and terms thereof to which they voluntarily bind themselves to comply. Consent may be expressly or implied. Consent is giving up one's conformity or pagsang-ayon ng dalawang parties that are involved in contract. It can be expressly or implied. Let's say for example, si Sammy nag-offer siya na ibenta kay Sachi yung car niya for 1 million. Si Sachi hindi niya alam, so dito papasok yung consent. Hindi pwedeng mabenta ni Sammy kay Sachi yung car dahil walang consent galing kay Sachi. So, pwede bang i-withdraw ni Sammy ang offer niya kay Sachi? Of course, kasi wala namang consent si Sachi na bibilin niya or wala namang naganap na meeting of the minds. The next is meeting of offer. Offer is a proposal made by one party to another to enter into a contract. It is more than an expression of desire or hope. It is a promise to act or to refrain from acting on condition that the terms thereof are accepted by the person to whom it is made. Offer must be certain and seriously intended. Ang offer ay yung mga bagay or serbisyo na inaalok ng isang offerer sa offeree. And offer must be certain and seriously intended. It must not be misleading. Dapat hindi lang siya nag-offer dahil gusto niya or what. The offer must be certain or seriously intended. The next is meaning of acceptance. Acceptance is the manifestation by the offeree of his assent to all the terms of the offer. Without acceptance, can be no meeting of the minds between the parties. Acceptance of offer must be clear and absolute. Ina-accept mo dapat yung ng buo, walang condition at hindi counter-offer. Like yung example ko kanina, magkakaroon lamang ng acceptance kung sinabi ni Sachi na yes, I'll buy it. It means that umagrees siya na bibili niya yung car, pero kung sinabi ni Sachi na pwede ko bang bilhin yung sasakyan mo for 800,000, that is a counter offer. Na-reject kasi yung unang offer since walang acceptance na ganap, wala ring meeting of minds na nangyari. And I just want to clarify this sentence na galing sa second paragraph ng Article 1319. It says that acceptance made by letter or telegram does not bind the offer except from the time it came to his knowledge. So, let's say for example, noong December 1, Sammy offered to sell her car to Sachi for 1 million by letter. Nagpadala siya ng sulat. Then, noong December 5, inaccept ni Sachi yung offer at nag-agree na bibilin yung car. Sachi sent a letter and wrapped it at the mailbox on December 10. While the letter is in course of mail, Sammy died or before accepting the offer. So the question is the contract is perfected? The answer is no. Diba sabi nga, magiging binding lang ang acceptance which is done through a letter was came to his or her knowledge. And then paano malalaman na may acceptance na kung namatay siya? So walang perfection of contract na naganap. The next article is Article 1320. An acceptance may be expressed or implied. When we say express acceptance, it is the form of a promise to pay a certain amount or to do something, maybe oral or written. Dito ina-accept mo yung isang offer through verbal or non-verbal. And next is implied acceptance. It is one that is inferred from act or conduct, as well as it is one that is not directly stated but it is demonstrated by any acts indicating a person's assent to the proposed bargain. Let's say for example ng express acceptance, signing a contract, orally accepting the offer, shaking hands, or even exchanging business cards with the offer and accepted terms. And sa implied naman, an implied acceptance occurs when a shopper selects an item in a supermarket and pays the cashier for it. The shopper's conduct indicates that he or she has agreed to the supermarket owner's offer to sell the item for the price stated on it. Additionally, it has been held that where a person accepts the services of another, whether solicited or not, he has the obligation to pay the reasonable value of the services thus rendered upon the implied contract of lease of services unless it is shown that the service was rendered gratuitously or without any expectation that he would pay for the same. So, sinasabi lang naman dito sa Article 1320 na ang acceptance, pwede mong i-accept yung isang offer whether it is express acceptance or implied acceptance. The next article is Article 1321. The person making the offer may fix the time, place, and manner of acceptance, all of which must be complied with. Matters that may be fixed by the offeror. The person making the offer has the right to prescribe the time, the place, and the manner of acceptance, all of which must be complied with. An acceptance departing from the terms of the offer constitutes a counteroffer. Take note that the counteroffer has the effect of extinguishing the offer. It in effect so constitutes a new offer which the original offer may accept or reject. So let's say for example, James as offeror may tell Nadine the offeree that the latter must accept the offer personally on February 11 before 5 o'clock p.m. in the office of James, all of which must be complied with by Nadine to create a contract. So sabi nga dito sa Article 1320 na ang person na nag-o-offer ay may karapatan na mag-prescribe ng time, ng place, and the manner of acceptance. Gaya dito kay James, he has the right to prescribe the time, the date, and the place kung saan sila pwede magkita personally ni Nadine para ma-accept yung offer and para magkaroon na sila ng contract. Communication of the offer. The offer must be communicated and received by the offeree. It may be by letter, telephone, email, or the like. It may be expressed or implied by the language or acts of the offeror understood as such by the other party. Let's say for example, Sammy attended an auction sale. When the auctioneer asked for a bid at a certain price upon antique furniture, Sammy nodded after getting the auctioneer's attention. The nod by Sammy constitutes an implied offer. It was a sufficient communication to the auctioneer of Sammy's intention to make a valid offer. Dito sa example, hindi man sila personally or directly na nakapag-usap si Sammy at yung auctioneer, meron naman silang communication, which is yung pagnod nga ni Sammy sa yung pagnod nga ni Sammy para makuha niya yung attention ng auctioneers. And with that, it was a sufficient communication to the auctioneers of Sammy's intention to make a valid offer. Let's go to Article 1322. An offer made through an agent is accepted from the time acceptance is communicated to him. Sa Tagalog, ang alok na ginawa sa pamamagitan ng isang ahente ay masasabing tinanggap ng pinag-alokan sa oras na tinanggap nito ang alok ng ahente. Let's go to communication of acceptance. To offeror, the acceptance of the offer must be supra. The other requisite is that the acceptance must be communicated to the offeror. The acceptance may be either expressed or implied in Article 1320, subject to the terms of the offer in Article 1321. The next is to agent. By legal fiction, an agent is considered an extension of the personality of his principal. Yung agent is siya yung nagre-represent sa principal or offeror. The Article 1322 means that when an offeror appoints a third person as his agent to represent him, the offer by the agent, when accepted by the offeree, is deemed or considered acceptance, not from the knowledge of the acceptance by the offeror, but from the moment of the agent has received that the communication of acceptance. The meeting of the minds is thus established. Dito sa Article 1322, the moment na nag-appoint ang principal or offeror ng agent niya to represent him at nag-alok na yung agent ng offer at tinanggap na ng offeree, masasabi na itong accepted. Kasi once na ma-communicate ni offeree kay agent yung acceptance, may consent na yon. Therefore, sapat na kahit sa agent lang ang communication yung acceptance, that is a valid agreement na. Let's say for example, Jordan is a representative of Washer Company Incorporated, the maker of aloe vera shampoo. He offered the company's product to Michael, the store manager, in a special promotional price. They both agreed with the terms and conditions in purchasing the product. The Washer Company Incorporated, being the owner, hired an authorized agent like Jordan who will represent their company. The agreement between Jordan and Michael is valid. Dito, sinasabi na si Jordan ay agent. Siya yung kumakatawan or nagre-represent sa Washer Company Incorporated. The moment na nagkaunawaan na sila with Michael, which is the store manager, valid na yung agreement. Additionally, Article 1322 applies only if the offer is made through the agent and the acceptance is communicated through him. Hence, there will be no meeting of the minds if the principal himself made the offer and the acceptance is communicated to the agent, unless, of course, the latter is authorized to receive the acceptance. Let's go to Article 1323. an offer becomes ineffective upon the death, civil interdiction, insanity, or insolvency of either party before acceptance is conveyed. In this article, sinasabi lang dito kung kailan ang offer ay maging ineffective or mawawala ng visa. Dahil ito sa death, insanity, insolvency, and civil interdiction. Yung death is yung kamatayan. And yung when we say civil interdiction, it is a mandatory accessory penalty deemed imposed whenever the sentence rendered is within the range of preclusion temporal to death. If the latter is not executed by reason of commutation or pardon. So, yung civil interdiction, ito yung pagtataw ng parusa sa isang taong nagkasala, whether pwede itong life imprisonment, reclusion perpetua, and reclusion temporal. And next is insanity, legal term for mental disorder, disease, or defect of the brain. Ito yung parang pagkawala sa sarili. And the next one is insolvency, inability or the lack of means to pay one's debt. Next is when offer becomes ineffective. An offer may be withdrawn before it is accepted. After acceptance, the contract is already perfected. Under Article 1323, even if the offer is not withdrawn, its acceptance will not produce a meeting of the minds in case the offer has already become ineffective because of the death, civil interdiction, insanity, or insolvency of either party before the conveyance of the acceptance to the offeror. Let's go to the example of death. Alia offered to sell her beach resort to Luis for the amount of 1.5 million pesos. But before the day that they are going to meet up for the payment and their contract will be made, Maria Mercedes died. Therefore, the meeting of the mind of the two parties become ineffective because of the death of Maria Mercedes. And let's go to the civil interdiction. In the preceding illustration, supposing that Alia was sentenced for life imprisonment because she was found guilty in murder case and there is no acceptance had been conveyed by Luis to Alia before the sale. Therefore, the offer made by Maria became ineffective because her sentence carried with civil interdiction. Next example is insanity. Same as the above illustration, if Alia became insane before Luis accepted her offer, the contract became ineffective because an insane person cannot give consent to a contract. And the last one is insolvency. Also, if Alia was declared by the court as an insolvent person due to her inability or lack of means to pay one's debt before Luis accepted the offer, therefore, the meeting of the minds of the parties is not valid because of the insolvency of the offeror. Due to other grounds which render offer ineffective, dito sa slide na to, or sinasabi dito, hindi lang ang debt, civil interdiction, insolvency, and insanity ang magpapawalang visa. Pwede rin dito yung failure to comply with the condition of the offer as to the time, place, and the manner of payment, which is na-discuss ko sa Article 1321. Next is the expiration of the period fixed in the offer for acceptance na tatalakayan natin sa Article 1324 and the destruction of the thing due before acceptance in Article 1262. Rejection of the offer, and etc. It will also render the offer ineffective and prevent the creation of a contract. Let's go to the Article 1324. When the offerer has allowed the offeree a certain period to accept, the offer may be withdrawn at any time before acceptance by communicating such withdrawal, except when the option is founded upon a consideration as something failed or promised. Let's go first to the meaning of option contract, option period, and option money. When we say option contract, it is one giving a person for a consideration of certain period within which to accept the offer of the offeror. It is separate and distinct from the contract which will be perfected upon the acceptance of the offeror. Ito yung mismong agreement nyo na may option period in which tatanggapin ng offeree yung offer. The next is option period. It is the period given within which the offeree must accept the offer. So, sa madaling salita, ito yung palugit na araw para ma-accept yung offer. The next one is option money. It is the money paid or promised to be paid in consideration for the option. It is not be confused with earnest money, which is actually a partial payment of the purchase price and is considered as proof of the perfection of the contract. When we say option money, in the name itself, may involve ng money para siyang paunang bayad, ganun. Let's say for example, may contract of sale, 500 pesos, pero binayad mo muna 100. So, yung 100 is option money, paunang bayad. Nagbayad ka ng 100 and then tinanggap na ng other party. Proof na siya ng perfection kasi meron ng requisites of contract. Ito yung consent, object, and cause. And the next slide is withdrawal of offer where period stipulated for acceptance. When the offeror gives to the offeree a certain period within which to accept the offer, the general rule is that the offer may be withdrawn as a matter of right at any time before acceptance. The exception is when the option is founded upon a consideration as something paid or promised, meaning if the offeror has allowed the offeree a certain period of time to accept, binigyan niya ng certain period like 30 days to accept the offer, based sa Article 1324, yung offer ay pwedeng ma-withdraw anytime before yung acceptance ni offeree. Papaano ma-withdraw? By means of communicating such withdrawal. Ipaalam mo lang na you no longer interested or you are no longer willing to sell the thing or yung offer mo originally. But then, this is not absolute. May exception pa rin. Gaya ng sabi ko sa last sentence, hindi mo pwedeng ma-withdraw yung offer kapag may naganap ng promise or paunang bayad, or should I say, option money. Think of it, magbabayad ka ba kahit partial yan kung hindi ka naman interesado? Hindi, di ba? Kaya ayan yung tinutukoy na exception. Dito sa Article 1324, sinasabi lang na ang offerer has the right to give the offeree a certain period to accept the offer. It may be withdrawn anytime before acceptance. Depende na lamang kung yung option is nagkaroon na ng consideration. It's something paid or promised or meron ng option money. And that would be all. Thank you. Stay safe and mabuhay!